ensure that the team is well established, that the continuity and in the succession, that the business does not suffer and so forth. And so I'm really honored to do that. And so effective today, Praveen is the managing director and CEO on an interim basis, and I'm going to become executive VC, executive vice chair. And I'm still here. I'm still an executive of the company responsible for I'll particularly focus on strategy and key client relationships, like Ravi said, and help Praveen and Ranga and Ravi and Mohit, Rajesh and the team in any way that I can. And we'll take it from there. So I have no plans. I have not thought about what I'm going to do next. So I just don't want to, before even we get there, I don't want to address anything there. I'm here until the 31st of March of next year, or sooner if we manage to get a great team put together by then. And so that's where we are. Otherwise, business continues as usual. And our team did an extraordinary job in Q1. And we are continuing that intense operational focus, the execution focus on Q2, this quarter that is currently underway, and we are going to keep that and continue that. And as you heard recently, yesterday or day before, I don't know when it was in India, Ranga and the team have announced that we got the approvals for the buyback, and as a part of the capital allocation policy that we had laid out earlier. We are really excited about that. The board is going to get together Saturday, which is tomorrow India time, but day after tomorrow for us, and going to work on that. So Ranga has been personally working extremely hard to get that done, and I'm really proud of the effort that the team has put together. So business and the execution of our work continues as usual, and we are going to have a very smooth transition here. Thank you very much. Praveen?
This is Ishisha. If you'd like to say a few things. Would Mr. Sheshishai like to see anything?
I think Ravi has already said all that we from the board have to say. Let me also add my word of thanks to Vishal for all that he has done to this company, for bringing a new level of energy into this company, setting a new direction and a purpose. All I need to add to all that Ravi has said is to say that as a board, we are fully committed to ensure that not only is the transition smooth, but we will do what it takes to get the right kind of leadership on a durable basis, and to also create an environment which is stable and will provide the right kind of atmosphere for a new leadership to move forward in the direction that the company has already chosen under Vishal for the new age. I must once again thank Vishal. Here I have an extraordinary relationship. We have enjoyed every moment of our association in the last 3 years that he has been with us. The mutual learnings have been very high. So I will continue to depend on him to lead the company in the months that he is going to be with us. And I have no doubt, given the fact that he so passionately believes in what he does, that the mere fact that he is going to move from a CEO to an EVC will make no difference to his commitment, will make no difference to all the initiatives that he has started. And I'm particularly glad that therefore we have the comfort that our commitment to the customers is not going to get disrupted. Our commitment to employees are not going to get disrupted. Both with Vishal and the fact that we have in Praveen, an extraordinary person with such strong values and long years of association. There's nothing about this company that does not have a good view. This is a great thing going But then, in history, in one's life, there are moments when changes become unavoidable. Sometimes these changes are very painful at the time that they occur, but then there is always a new path that emerges, and we do hope that such a path will emerge and we will work towards that. And I want to take this opportunity to commit ourselves doubly in not merely in terms of the time and effort, but also in ensuring that we find a way to provide the stability to the company. So I will now be happy to take on questions, Ravi and I, and Vishal will take on questions. I know there must be plenty of them today, but we are quite happy to do work again. Thank you.
Thank you. We'll take the first question from Shilpa from Times of India.
Sorry, can't hear you.
Shilpa, maybe you can speak into the microphone. Yeah.
Yes, sir. The board has publicly supported Mr. Sikka, but we get a sense that there is some sort of a dissidence among certain board members that made them say that Vishal is non-CEO material. So why is there, are there cracks in the board? And secondly, was that statement misconstrued? Ravi Venkateshan also pointed out that it's difficult to get an external candidate to run Infosys at this stage. Can you talk about the search and will you be in contention for the top job?
Okay, well, we've got...
Ravi, you want to take that?
I think so, Sesh, because she's got straight to the heart of the matter. I think you're referring to some comments in a letter that made its way to the media yesterday. First of all, for the last year or so, the board has been in dialogue with the founder, with the promoters, to try and find some practical solutions, feasible solutions to different points of view within the boundaries of the law and without compromising our independence. Now, we were making reasonable progress until quite recently. Now, these are privileged conversations. And if you take a remark without out of context, without the full context of the discussion, they can appear to be quite problematic. So there is no question that Vishal is a phenomenal technical guy. I mean, I don't have to say it. I think the world understands that. What is evident is that he has also blossomed into a high-performing CEO. If you look at the results that he talked about, which we have stated not once but repeatedly, it is evident that he and the leadership team have done a fine job delivering operating and financial results. When things don't go right, we tend to blame a leader. When things go right, it is equally important that the recognition for that must also